Hi everyone. As a South Indian woman married to a North Indian guy, there's definitely some really different experiences and some funny experiences and some blunders which can happen just because you're not really completely aware of the other person's background or culture and stuff like that. So in this video, I wanted to share a few big blunders which I have made as a South Indian married to a North Indian husband who's from Lucknow and I'm from Bengaluru. In South India, we usually use mustard seeds for all our tadka and all the sabji or whatever cooking. So the use of jeera in vegetables was very limited, and it was just very, very, very occasionally that we would use jeera, or either we grind it up and add it in some masala or something like that, but usually it's mustard seeds in all the tadka which we use. Okay, and nobody from my husband's side's family knows this until now, but I guess now they would come to know. I used something else in place of jeera, which I was sure was jeera, and my husband used to keep saying something's a little off with this, you know, but it took us a couple of months to figure out what I was doing. Because of that sort of similarity in how it looks, or at least to me it looked similar, I have used sauf in the place of jeera for the first couple of months, confidently thinking that I am using jeera, and I had no clue that I was actually using sauf until one day my husband figured it out. If I had tasted the sauf / jeera before using it in tadka, I would have known. Come on, who tastes jeera before adding it into anything, right? So I had no clue, and I was using sauf. So yeah, that's big blunder number one. The second thing is, it's a North Indian custom that whenever you meet elders of the family, you usually touch their feet. And this is not something we do regularly in the South, but it's a regular daily basis sort of activity in Northern India. So my husband had warned me after marriage when we were visiting some other relatives, you know, if you meet them, you know, any elders, just make sure that you touch their feet. And we had a code. You don't necessarily have to touch everyone's feet. May not be like some neighbors or some distant auntie or something. It means my husband's father's elder brother. And we visited their house, and they had like a servant quarters attached where there was another family staying who would help them with their daily chores and stuff like that. And I had only met everyone at the wedding, so I didn't really know who's exactly who and how many people are in their house, and I didn't have a complete idea of who is Jijaji, what does he look like, and how everyone in the family looks like. So when I entered, first I think my husband's Tauji came out and I touched his feet, and then behind him was his driver, and I had no clue, and I didn't want to make the mistake of, you know, not touching someone's feet or coming across as not respectful in the first visit. So I went and touched the driver's feet, and he almost like took off and freaked out a bit, and so did my relatives, just not knowing who kiska pair chuna hai and kiska nahi chuna hai was one of the biggest dilemmas initially. But now I think I'm a little more sorted on that. That took some getting used to, definitely. So that was the second blunder which I did. Okay, now coming to the third blunder. My connection with anything North Indian or Hindi was only through Bollywood for the longest time. Like after studying Hindi in school, we never used to speak it regularly or even converse in Hindi on a daily basis ever. It was only by watching Bollywood movies that, you know, my Hindi sort of, I remembered some of it in life basically. My first Holi in Lucknow after the wedding, I thought that, you know, Holi means everyone's wearing white clothes and there's music and people are throwing Holi powder in the air and dancing around and dhol and music playing loudly everywhere, and that was my impression of how Holi is, because in every movie song related to Holi, everyone's in white. For my first Holi there, I went prepared with, you know, like a full white kurta and a full like, you know, proper like jewelry and everything, and just making sure that I would try to look like how the Bollywood heroines or anyone actually looks in these Holi songs and Holi scenes. When I went there and saw like the neighbors and the friends and cousins and relatives, whomever we met, I was shocked because everyone had kept like a pair of old clothes or like a nightie or something that they would be willing to discard off after the festival. And I was really shocked and embarrassed, and I think it became a little bit of a joke because of naivety or lack of knowledge on how Holi is actually played. Even before going to Lucknow for the first Holi after the wedding, I had played Holi in Bangalore a couple of times where with my college friends or something. It was like a new concept for us, something to try. And then I had used like old purana clothes, which you know, you want to throw off, that sort of thing. But I thought it's so different in Lucknow and so different in North India, and I thought that's like the authentic way to celebrate the festival. So I made like a royal fool of myself on that day and unnecessarily spoiled a nice white kurta, and I learned my lesson on that day. So that was like the third blunder which I've done.